Guys, ready?
Everything in my life has been leading up to this point. I am... I believe I am ready for this.
Belief is a powerful thing.
What comes of this? I need to know you all.
Captain, you have an uncanny talent for complicating my life.
Well, someone's got it.
You've been working with Dr. Wells from the beginning.
Who, me?
When we moved to arrest him, he was prepared. I lost good soldiers in the attempt.
Fine, good.
You've disrupted the balance of power. You've upset the natural order of things.
Oh, please.
You've introduced uncertainty, and there is nothing I despise more than uncertainty.
You sure love talking. Do they pay you by the word?
Typical. Running your mouth in the middle of a crisis. It's almost as if you delight in chaos.
Hey, embrace it.
I should have dealt with you a long time ago. You were always too dangerous to leave unchecked.
Oh, stop. You're making me blush.
I suppose I shouldn't be surprised by your impertinence. Leaving you alive was my greatest mistake. But it is a mistake I intend to correct.
Yeah, we'll see.
I have Dr. Wells in my custody. Once I've secured his cooperation, I can move forward with the program. I can repair the damage you've done. I can set things right.
You don't understand. Phineas is my friend. I'm not leaving without him.
Well, that's mostly correct. You're not leaving here at all.
Yeah, huh?
You were one of my finest agents once. I don't want to destroy you. Turn yourself in, and I may yet show clemency.
Why, Madam Adjutant, I'm touched. I didn't know you cared.
I don't, you perfidious turncoat. You know-
Oops.
Never mind. Now I regret saying anything at all.
Alright, well, let's talk about this.
Fair enough. I'm giving you exactly one chance to parlay with me.
Just looking at these other options. You're one of the only rational people left. Can't choose that. Intimidate 90 and heavy weapons 60 and two melee handed 60. Wow. Intimidate. Can't do that either. That has a lot of prerequisites. You don't want to die on Tartarus. I'm giving you a chance to walk away.
Interesting that you think I'm going to die here. I believe I'm more than capable of taking you on.
Nothing stopped me so far. What makes you think you will?
Fair point. I don't know how you've managed to defy the odds. By every reasonable estimate, you should be dead. Yet here you stand.
Ta-da!
I've devoted my entire life to protecting Halcyon. I'm not afraid to die in the line of duty.
Sophia, the board is not worth dying for.
There isn't much of a board left, thanks to you. You've thrown this system into disarray. Cleaning up your mess will be the work of a lifetime. You were always an unknown variable. I tried to recruit you, but you threw your lot in with that madman, Phineas Wells.
I'm surprised I actually have Science 90. Dr. Wells and I are both scientists. We believe Halcyon can still be saved.
I'm aware of Dr. Wells' plan. Revive some brilliant scientists and engineers from the Hope and work with them to save the colony. He's already revived you, after all. 50 or 60 years ago, I might have agreed with you. But we've passed the point of no return. The best scientists in Halcyon can't save us now.
It's gonna take a miracle to save Halcyon, but we can do it if we work together.
I appreciate your confidence, Captain. But so long as you're allied with Dr. Wells, we can never work together. I haven't given up on the program yet. You've caused some complications, but I can improvise. I can fix this. I haven't lost control of the labyrinth yet. Our security system is still operational. I can still put a stop to you.
I've left a lot of corpses behind me, Sophia. Are you sure you want to be next?
When you put it that way, no. Not in the least.
Three checks.
Damn it all. Very well. You win.
Yay!
I'm familiar enough with your methods to realize my chances of survival are low.
Yeah, let's live.
Congratulations, Captain. You've outplayed me. I accept your terms and will return Dr. Wells to your care.
Checkmate. Drop the Adversary Act. Okay, thank you. I'm glad we could settle this without violence.
I just hope you've made the right decision.
Me too.
The fate of the colony is in your hands now. I bid you farewell, Captain.
Fare thee well. Sophia's key. Okay, I see that. We still gotta fight our way through this crap, I'm sure. You just take a look over here. Is there another one standing here? There's one big one. Oh, that's sealed. So I guess we're going this way. So that's the enemy thing right there. Now we got 2, 3. We have many. Okay, we got many. Maybe that means since we talked to her, we can just go back here and get the key. We don't have to fight all that stuff. It basically looks like we bypassed it all. I just want to take a look around here. There's that thing that I guess we don't have to fight. Sure, you guys would like to see me fight it, but... if I don't have to, I won't. With Sophia dealt with, rescue Phineas from his cell. Got it. Well, he looks alert. Oh.
You don't know how glad I am to see you.
Phineas!
You must have said something to get under Akande's skin.
A few
she's
things.
She's gone, and I don't think she's coming back.
Awesome.
And you, you lunatic! You broke into the board's own fortress just to rescue one doddering old man!
Damn right!
You are absolutely out of your mind, and I can't begin to thank you enough.
Hey, no problem. From one lunatic to another, Phineas. You're all right, though? What did they do to you?
I'm all right, thanks to you. Akande wanted my cooperation. I'm quite sure she would have beaten it out of me if you hadn't arrived. You've broken the board's stranglehold on this colony, and you saved my life. But there's still so much we have yet to accomplish. You and I are going to have to work harder than ever to save Halcyon. I'm afraid the situation is far worse than any of us ever anticipated.
Well, it's just great. I was about to pop open some drinks and celebrate, too.
I would like nothing more than to celebrate this victory, but we have a serious problem on our hands.
Starvation of colonists?
Earth has gone dark.
Oh.
We haven't received a single message in 3 years. There's been no communication, no signals, nothing. 2 years ago, the Earth's Directorate's frigate disappeared on their way back to Earth. We don't know what they discovered when they arrived, or if they arrived at all.
Earth is only an idea to us. But that idea is the bedrock the colony is built upon. If people were to find out it's gone dark, the shock could be too much to bear.
I don't want to imagine what'll happen once news gets out. Let's just keep this between us for now.
I agree.
You mean, we're all alone out here? Really alone?
I'm afraid so, Miss Holcomb. Halcyon is the only home we have left. Returning to Earth is no longer an option. We're in serious trouble, my friend. Do you know what this means for Halcyon? We can't rely on Earth for support anymore. We've been cut loose. We're entirely on our own.
Yeah, I wonder what's happened. I wonder if they're just not in a... if they're not able to respond, but are otherwise okay? Well, you can never know. The Earth could be, poof, gone. Or just... the human race on the Earth extinct. I mean, the, where we are the remains of humanity. Can I ask you something?
Yes, yes, certainly. I'll help however I can.
What do you think happened?
I don't know what happened, but something must have gone horribly wrong. I don't know why Earth's gone silent. I don't even know if Earth exists anymore. We have no connection back to Earth, and return is likely impossible. We're completely alone out here.
You mentioned a frigate disappearing.
You might have heard of the Earth Directorate's frigate. Half the colony's entire military was on that ship. They were returning to Earth when they vanished without a trace. That was 2 years ago. We haven't heard a word from them since. Whatever happened to Earth likely happened to them.
Nothing vanishes without a trace. There's something else. I know about the other colonists, Phineas.
I wasn't trying to hide the truth from you, but after all you've done, I owe you an explanation. Yes, I experimented on the Hope's colonists. Each of my experiments ended in catastrophic failure. Each of my subjects died in agony. You are my first and only success. I didn't tell you about the others because I didn't want to burden you. My failures are my own to bear, not yours.
I don't think it's up to me to forgive him or not. Well, better late than never, I guess.
I'm not asking you to forgive me.
Good, because I didn't say I would.
I won't forgive myself, but I'm going to try to set things right. My apologies. I need to get a hold of myself. We've far more pressing issues to worry about right now. If you have any more questions, ask me. I'll answer as best I can.
I don't have any more questions. We've got some work to do, that's for sure.
Yes, we do. You've done a marvelous thing. You've succeeded where anyone else would have failed, including me.
Yeah, well...
we must begin the revival process immediately, starting with the Hope's brightest minds. And then we're going to fix this damn colony, one problem at a time.
Let's go get him.
We're going to need a leader, and I can't imagine a better person for the job than you. What do you say, old friend? Will you help us?
Whatever I want, all the time. A leader. A leader running the colony? What's the difference between these two options? Meaning, this is the chairman is basically a figurehead with me running the colony. Otherwise, I'm running the colony and everyone knows. And the chairman's going to take my side. Yeah, I'm going to run this colony myself. I've already convinced the chairman to take my side.
The chairman? I don't know why you let that heartless creature live, but I'll have to trust your judgment.
I don't have a choice, really.
You're the best thing to ever happen to Halcyon. If you want to take it upon yourself to lead this colony, you have my support. We're not a colony any longer, are we? Our last connection to Earth has been severed, and so we have been set free.
I suppose so.
Our future is uncertain, and no one knows what tomorrow holds. Exciting, isn't it?
Yeah.
The OSI teaches that everything in the universe happens according to the grand plan. But the stranger that arrived in Halcyon was an unplanned variable. From the moment she landed in Emerald Vale, her actions altered the course of history. The events on Tartarus brought about the end of the Board's authority. But the Board's mistakes would haunt the colony for decades to come. The damage they left behind would require the work of a generation to repair. Dr. Phineas Wells began reviving a handful of the Hope's colonists. Engineers, scientists, technicians, and intellectuals. They were among the brightest minds the Earth had ever sent out into the stars. The Hope scientists and engineers woke up in a colony descending headlong into total collapse. With no way to return to Earth, they had no choice but to band together and devote themselves to the cause of saving Halcyon. The people of Halcyon were nothing if not hardy. In the absence of the Board's authority, many of the colony's settlements banded together with a single purpose in mind: survival. Life was especially hard in the years to come. Some towns dissolved by attrition and starvation, but most of them found a way to carry on. In the years to come, Halcyon was forced to reckon with its newfound freedom. The Board was gone, and for better or worse, the colony was responsible for its own destiny. Between MSI's worker-centric policies and the iconoclast's manpower, Sanjar and Zora were able to rally many of the Terra II townships to their cause. MSI's workforce swelled, and the iconoclasts enjoyed a significant surge in their ranks. The Board was too distracted by infighting and internal politics to stop MSI from becoming a powerful corporation and a refuge for townships that might have fallen through the cracks. Consumed by paranoia, Lilia Hagen took sublight salvage in a controversial direction, openly accusing Board officials of an extraterrestrial conspiracy. One day, an accident at the Groundbreaker's docking bay silenced her forever.
Oops.
Time would tell if her replacement could keep the sublight family together.
Well, that's surprising.
Adelaide McDevitt replaced Reed Thompson as the leader of Edgewater. She and her followers transformed Edgewater in their image. Anyone loyal to Reed was pressured into leaving town, and those who stayed behind adapted to her way of life. Adelaide transformed the old cannery into a new garden. The nearby Edgewater Cemetery provided a convenient source of fertilizer.
Mm-hmm.
As for Reed Thompson, it was said that he lasted exactly 2 days outside the walls of Edgewater. Years later, a marauder was found in possession of his hat.
Surprise, was that
long?
Under
the leadership of Junlei Tennyson, the Groundbreaker held firm against corporate influence. The ship's mechanical stability gave Junlei the time to educate a promising generation of engineers schooled in her family's traditions. The future of the Groundbreaker looks promising. The rediscovery of the Hope and the abandonment of the lifetime employment program
forced
Byzantium to come to terms with some uncomfortable realities about the state of Halcyon. While Byzantines were reluctant to surrender the luxuries they'd grown accustomed to...
Too bad.
The board's diminished authority gave them little choice in the matter. Nearly everyone had to learn to make do with less. Some even had to get jobs.
The horror.
It was a dark time indeed. Your influence shifted Ellie's perspective. She finally admitted, albeit grudgingly, that she just might need other people. Sometimes. With a steady income from the life insurance payouts, she was finally able to afford a ship of her own. She hired a small crew and flew supply missions to communities on the fringe. Some of them were even legal.
Some of them.
Life in Halcyon was sobering for Felix Millstone. The grand revolution he dreamed of never came. There was no great awakening for the colony, no celebrations in the streets. There was only the hard, desperate work of trying to repair a broken colony. Felix never had a head for numbers, but if there was labor to be done, he was there to help. Eventually, Felix realized that the work of a revolution was done with two hands.
That's right.
As much as he enjoyed his adventures aboard the Unreliable, the vicar, known as Max, eventually decided that it was time to move on, to live out the life he had sought so long to create.
Aw, Miss Max.
He knew there were many in the colony who carried burdens much worse than the ones he had struggled with, and he devoted himself to easing their suffering wherever he could. He only ever took up arms again to defend the defenseless. Unshackled from a lifetime of striving and fighting the universe and himself, Vicar Maximilian de Soto was finally at peace. Though Parvati eventually grew comfortable aboard the Unreliable, she never quite came out of her shell. She seemed to prefer the company of Ada to the crew, and she could often be found neck deep in cables and grease, telling Ada funny stories from her childhood. While the colony fell into chaos, she found an island of relative peace with Ada, and they formed an unusual bond. She decided to remain aboard the Unreliable permanently as its chief and sole engineer. Miyoko returned to Monarch to take another crack at making a permanent life for herself. She formed the Charon Group, a mercenary outfit of ragtag survivalists and wilderness experts. Anyone in need of a guide, or just looking to throw back a beer and swap stories, could find her camping on the trail, or clearing an infestation. The SAM unit that accompanied you spread awareness of the product line's superior sanitation and maintenance capabilities across what was left of the colony. This led to a boost in SAM unit sales.
Hmm.
Did you know that SAM units are the longest-lasting, toughest-acting cleaning solution in Halcyon? Minister Clark was released from house arrest, and his contact with you gave him a sense of renewed purpose and vigor. Once it became clear that no help would be coming from Earth, he threw his considerable efforts and talents into helping Halcyon manage the crisis before it.
That's awesome.
It was widely suspected that Sophia Akande was the true power behind Chairman Rockwell. However, after the riots on Tartarus, she was never again seen in the colony. Various theories circulated as to her fate. Some believed she boarded an interstellar ship capable of journeying to a distant colony. Others believed she died trying to escape Tartarus. Some few suggest she fled to Monarch, where she continued to live among a small band of loyalists. There is another theory, which suggests that Sophia's encounter with you changed her, and she deliberately retreated from public view, but continued supporting the colony in secret. When Dr. Wells began reviving the Hope's colonists, he found himself with a sudden windfall of additional supplies and resources, courtesy of an anonymous donor.
Was it her?
If Wells knew who his supplier was, he never told a soul. As for Dr. Phineas Wells, he spent his remaining years in his orbital lab. He eventually came to terms with his own past and was able to forgive the mistakes of his younger self by devoting his remaining years to serving the colony. In the end, Dr. Wells was able to save every scientist and engineer aboard the Hope.
Awesome.
Over the next decade, nearly all of the Hope's remaining colonists were successfully revived. Halcyon saw a period of rapid technological and scientific advancement. Breakthroughs in dietary supplements saved the colony from starvation.
Sweet.
Geoengineering projects and social reforms began to change the structure and character of the colony. Dr. Wells laid the groundwork for the project to save the colony, but he would never live to see the fruits of his labor. He passed away a few years later. His work was carried on by the scientists and engineers he revived. Today, Halcyon has stabilized. The people of the colony work hard to adapt to their new circumstances. Nearby colonies send aid and supplies. Life will never be easy in Halcyon, but for the first time in its history, there exists a sense of real, genuine hope about the future.
So there's other colonies?
And what about you? The unplanned variable in the history of Halcyon.
Outside of Halcyon?
You brought an end to the riot on Tartarus and partnered with Chairman Rockwell to run the colony together. As Halcyon looked toward the future, you remained a constant presence in the colony's administration. You were never weighed down by bureaucracy, and you never had to dirty your hands with politics. You had people who did that for you. By your influence, Halcyon survived the turbulent years that were to follow. No one knows what's happened to Earth, and no one knows what the future has in store for Halcyon. All we know for certain is this: the name of the Unreliable and that of its intrepid captain will remain the subject of countless stories for years to come.
Wow. That was an awesome ending. That was the Fallout 1, I believe Fallout 2 ending with all the, basically catching up on everyone with still shots. Good homage to the original Fallout games. So, what do you guys think of the game? It was awesome. I'm really looking forward to the DLC that they're coming out with sometime this year, 2020. At the time of this recording, they have not revealed when in 2020. I believe the Switch version is coming out. The Switch port is coming out in June, so maybe it will come out in June along with that. Some people have been wondering. It's possible. I think it's awesome. Some people have said the combat was a little simplistic. I thought it was great. I'm pretty easy to please with RPGs. This could have had, I guess, the story was good. It could have a little something, you know, it kind of played it safe as far as everything goes, but basically this is really close to what Mass Effect Andromeda should have been, I think. Mass Effect Andromeda had awesome combat and such, but the characters and the story was just meh. This is much better, much improved. Definitely a step above Fallout 4, which I've heard of. Heard a lot about, and well, definitely more than Fallout 76. I don't need to play those games to know that this is better, at least on many different aspects. The reason why Parvati did not... Obsidian University. I still think it's so funny. The reason why Parvati did not come out of her shell, because I did not do her quest, because I thought I could romance Parvati, and I was getting jealous of Jun Lang. But apparently what I read recently is that... Oh, Tim Kaine, Robert for being a gentlemanly patient. You can't romance anyone in this game. Maybe in a DLC, that would be great if they would add that. But I heard that's the same with Fallout New Vegas? I don't know. Development babies. So, yeah, I really enjoyed it. Is it a perfect game? No. I'd give it a 7.5, if we have to go whole numbers, 8 out of 10. Not as good as Mass Effect 1 or 2, in my opinion. Better than Mass Effect 3. Way better than Mass Effect Andromeda. The music is amazing. And I love Parvati. I love Max. Sam is cool. I love Phineas. I liked at the end how all the people that you helped along the way would come and help you. I assume those people would not be there otherwise. The MSI people, the iconoclasts. If you were not helpful with them, I would assume they would not show up to help you. And most of them survived, which is great. Very often in games like this, when people like run in temporarily to help you, most of them end up dying and I feel terrible. So I think we only lost like 3 people out of everyone. So I'm really eager to see what they come out with next as far as the DLC, what it is. I'm guessing it's something we're going to load the save from before we went to Tartarus, I guess, and to go into that. But whenever that comes out, I'll be playing it. I'll probably, you know, have a video or two on about it right away. So you can bet on that. But I want to thank you guys so much for watching. I'm blabbing on and on with my little mini review. There's a lot of things about this game that I really enjoy. I like the sound effects are really well done. The music, as I said, is awesome. The graphics are awesome. It's a big surprise to me from Obsidian. After playing, you know, the South Park game, which is not really that great graphics because it's South Park style, and then Pillars of Eternity. It's been a while since they've come out with a game like this. And it's a lot of work has been put on it. A lot of work has been put into it. And from what I hear, it did pretty well, so hopefully they made plenty of money off of it. And we could see an Outer Worlds 2 at some point. What about these other colonies, though? Like, the Halcyon colony covers this whole solar system. And now at the end, we're hearing about another colony, or colonies, sending supplies. So are there other colonies? Oh, I love that. There's that guitar riff. So I was not aware that there's like a Halcyon colony, and then there's like another colony and another colony. How many colonies are there? I guess they're sending us supplies, so they're doing better off than we are. So are they completely different? Do they not have this corporate kind of heel that everyone's was corporate boot that everyone was getting ground under? Or is it more Spacer's Choice crap over there and Rizzo's and everything? Maybe that's what we'll be discovering in the Outer Worlds too. I want to thank you guys once more for watching. Thanks so much for coming on this journey with me. Hope to see you guys in another Let's Play. And always, seek adventure.